Beast is a 2022 Tamil action thriller film written and directed by Nelson and stars Vijay, Pooja Hegde, Selvaragavan, Yogi Babu, and Redden Kingsley, among others. Beast is a movie that I was really, really looking forward to because the director and the writer for this film is the same guy who did Doctor, which, if you don't know, was, according to me, one of the best films of 2022. It was even on my list at that time. That movie was expertly made, like fantastic execution and on that movie. Vijay's previous film was Master, which I think was in 2020 or something like that. I'm not sure. In which he fights with Sethupathi, you know, Sethupathi as the villain. And I also thought that the movie was good. So I had a good time in the theater watching Master. I unfortunately did not have a good time with Beast. This is Nelson's weakest work, and this is something that I did not want to say or did not expect to say for a Nelson movie, because the movie that I saw here previous to this was so expertly made, and the comedy was in it is so strong that I just couldn't believe my eyes when I watched Beast, and this is what came out of it. Like, I don't see any passion for this at all. There's hardly a story here. And this is the second time after Sanak, I think, that I'm seeing a hijack movie fail. Watch Die Hard. They made like 4 movies and a garbage one. They made 4 really good movies, and you watch the first one, it's essentially the same thing. Terrorists come up to a building and hijack it. And that was infinitely more entertaining. Even now, that is infinitely more entertaining than the 2 movies we got. Like, it pains me to say this, but I actually did watch Beast in theaters, even first day, on the first day itself. And I'm releasing this out of order a little bit because I want KGF 2 to be known first. And most likely, by the time I put this review anyway, would have stopped in theaters, much like Edhargum Thunindavan. By the time I put the video out, it wasn't playing in Bangalore, it was only playing in Tamil Nadu. So I'm expecting similar things here. And this not getting much reviews anyway, I'm thinking it will be the same thing where it would just run on Tamil Nadu for a little bit and overseas. This is a very underwhelming project from both Vijay and Nelson. Originally, A.R. Murugadas was supposed to be directing this, but he refused to change his salary or, you know, reduce his salary after the failure of Darbar. So Nelson came up and did it, and that's how Beast was made. And the biggest problem with this movie, or let me just get to the positives.
1 eternity later.
The action is cool. Like, the only time people, Vijay fans, actually got up from their seats and celebrated it, worshipped him, was during the action scenes. That's the only time when people actually got entertained here. All that whistling and everything, you know how, you know, fans are. That only happened in the action scenes, and that's done well. And remember, some of the action scenes are a bit silly. Like, Vijay at one point puts on some roller skates and does action scene in roller skates. There's a scene ripped straight out of Fast and Furious, and that's, I think that's the intermission. But he eventually gets up in a Mini Cooper and then just drives. That's the intermission. It's straight up Fast and Furious, man. And that's pretty much it. The best song in the movie, Arabi Kutu, is the first song in the movie. So everything went downhill from there. The build up, like when it's just them, or when it's just Vijay and the supporting cast just talking, it was so boring at that point that I just really, it was really frustrating. And once it got to the action scene, I was really entertained. Once the terrorists enter the mall, you know, the East Coast Mall, that's when the movie actually got entertaining, because that's where the action is. Then there's a portion in the middle where it again becomes slow and it's just the characters talking. It again becomes boring. Then it again cuts back to the action. I kind of, the whole interaction aspect from Doctor is completely missing here. Pooja Hegde is useless in this film. She's just a love interest. That's it. She's eye candy. And later in the movie, she's just a possessive girlfriend. That's it. There's a guy who's her fiance, sort of. And he's like so cringe. Like, why did Nelson think that was comic in any way? Yogi Babu and Renny Kingsley and some of the comic actors from Doctor is also present here. And this is their worst work yet. Hardly nothing evokes laughter. Like, I think the audience laughed once. That's it. The villain is the absolute worst. He's not threatening at all. There's nothing about him that made me feel like we're in danger. I mean, the dude hijacks a building, but hardly, I think, two people died. That's it. And there's nothing more to it. Brother is a dwarf, a very short person. It was odd at first, but then I was like, all right. But the biggest problem with the film, and the reason that I would ask you to avoid this, is that there's hardly any tension in the film. There's not a single scene which makes you feel like, oh shit, you know, kind of like Doctor when Shivakarthikeyan is like brutally beaten up in the climax. You would go, oh shit, how is he going to get out of that? In here, there's nothing like that. There's not a single scene which makes you feel that way. Well, think of Superman fighting a tree. That's how this movie is. It's that bad. It's that tensionless. Everything is a piece of cake for him. Like, there's hardly a scene which presented as a challenge to him. He cuts off like 10 people with a knife, and he kills like several people wearing roller skates. Trust me, there's hardly any tension. At bare minimum, in his previous venture, Master, there's at least a little bit of tension as to how he's going to defeat Sethupathi, because, you know, his one punch would mean broken bones and inability to fight for some time. So he really had to strategize, and that's how he wins. And the main terrorist guy dies in like 5 seconds. 5 seconds! Like, Vijay bursts through the door, riddles him with bullets, and then that's it. And I also did not like the color grading. It was way too saturated, similar to, I think, my videos, but even more saturated. It felt like I was watching a Hindi TV serial for some reason. The close-up shots were fine, but when it's like a shot like this, when it's shot like that, it seemed way too polished. It never felt right. I had the same feeling in the trailers as well, but I thought they would fix it in the movie, but nope, it's still there. And the supporting characters are basically useless. Like, I don't really get why Yogi Babu needs to be in this film, or any of the other characters for that matter. He hardly needed their help in any way. In Doctor, it was more of like a group effort, you know? And even in Master, I think Vijay needed the help of several people in order to motivate him to beat up Sethupathi. Here, there's none. He does everything by himself. There's hardly a challenge, and it's emotionless. There's not a single character which, even if it died, you wouldn't even really care. Overall, this was a very average film, I would say, because there's so many things wrong with the film, but I wouldn't say it was completely bad film, because the action in the movie was entertaining enough for me to not get bored too much. I would say it's pretty average, but as a theater experience, I would say nah. I would wait for it to come on OTT, considering since Sun Pictures is a production company for Beast. I'd say this would come out on Sun and NXT. And probably on Netflix. I'm not sure about that, but it will come on Sun and NXT. I suggest you watch it there once and then just forget about it. It was very underwhelming, and it's something that I would say you avoid watching in theaters. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and please don't forget to check out more of my videos. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.